It's a new day at Bethel AME Church after school program. Fruits, vegetables, salsa dip, and old school games like red light, green light are in. Out are sugary treats and drinks, and free for all playtime. Bethel went all in and adopted the healthy eating exercise approach based on a program introduced by researchers in the Arnold School of Public Health at the University of South Carolina.
It's really pervasive across all of these providers that they struggle in meeting these healthy eating and physical activity standards that have been adopted at a national level. And so what we're really trying to do is develop low to no cost strategies that anybody can use. And oftentimes it deals with just, what do I have to spend for snack? What's my budget? Knowing those costs. Where do I purchase my snack? You know, maybe
in 2011, Associate Professor Michael Beetz and his staff launched the Healthy Eating Physical Activity Project for four YMCA after-school programs. A whopping 500 sites responded to that initial call. Today, there are more than 20 sites that have adopted the philosophy, a two-pronged Healthy Eating and Physical Activity Project. Researchers are coaching program staff leaders to take a deliberate approach in planning healthy food and fun. Some programs are located in community centers, some schools and churches, giving the researchers a broad cross-section of providers. Exercise Science PhD candidate Keith Brazendale has been working with faith-based Bethel AME Church the past 2 years. He says Bethel has made enormous strides in its progress.
In terms of where we were wanting them to go with healthy eating and physical activity, we were seeing some undesirable behaviors, especially in terms of what they were serving for their snack. And then we saw some room for improvement in their physical activity environment that we could sort of help them with.
And improve it did. Gone are the sweet snacks like cookies and Kool-Aid and the fat saturated potato chips. These days, these hungry after-schoolers are feeding their faces with oranges, baked chips with salsa, and water. Yes, water. But it wasn't an easy sell for the kids or the staff.
Everybody was resistant to change. And when we implemented the change, we all enjoyed it. We all enjoy eating healthier, eating the fruits, eating the vegetables. Just learning how to eat different is just so much better for us.
Sherry Louie and her staff assistant, Alethi James, are drinking the healthy eating Kool-Aid, so to speak, and also reevaluating the physical activity by asking themselves if their students are really as active as they could be. Using the program principles from the slogan, Let Us Play, which stands for lines, elimination, team sizes, uninvolved staff and kids, space, equipment, and rules. Brazendale says they're not expecting Louie and Ames to have the skills of a phys ed teacher, but just want them to be more active with the kids.
And the two ladies that run this program here, Miss Ames and Miss Louie, have really taken this philosophy by the horns. They're actively engaging in activities with the children. They're promoting physical activity by verbally encouraging, and then they're looking at their active environment and saying, how can I make this more active using the Let Us Play principles.
They have learned to stop eating junk food. They have learned that physical activity can be fun. It's challenging, but it can be fun. And so I believe that they will take that, you know, along the way with them throughout their schooling years.